Hello friends, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of SSIS tutorial. So today we're gonna discuss about audit transformation. So what is audit transformation and when we can use this transformation? So let's start. So it includes data about the environment in which package will run, and it also allows us to add extra columns with audit information like machine name, package name, username and many more columns. So when we can use this transformation? When we want to check which user executed the package, what was the execution time, what was the machine name, what was the package name and what was the task name. So if we want such type of information, then we have to use audit transformation. So here we have a scenario. Like we can see, we have a SQL Server table and we want to load data from SQL Server table to flat file destination. And between this, we want to capture the audit information like machine name, package name, username and execution time. So we have to use audit transformation. So let's have a look of SQL Server table. So go to on SSMS. Then we have sale information table. Now I want to execute this query. So once we execute this selected statement, then we can see we have total 6 columns: sale order number, sale order date, customer ID, quantity, value and country. So we want to load this data in our flat file. So go to on SSDT. Here we need to create one more package. So right click on this SSIS package, then new SSIS package. So here we need to rename this package. So I gonna rename this package with audit. So here we need to use data flow task. So I gonna drag and drop data flow task, then double click on this data flow task. So inside data flow panel, we need to configure our source, transformation and destination. So as we have discussed, we have SQL Server table. So we have to use OLADB source. So I gonna drag and drop this OLADB source, double click on this OLADB source. So here we need to select the OLADB connection manager. So I gonna click on new. So we have already made the connection. So I gonna use this connection. So click on OK. Now we need to select the table. So as we have discussed, we have sale information table. So we need to select sale information table. So this is our sale info table. Go to on columns. So we want to capture all the columns. So we are OK with it. Now click on OK. So we have done our source. Now we need to configure our transformation. So we have audit transformation. So we need to drag and drop this audit transformation and then connect with source. Now double click on this audit transformation. So here we can see we have output column names, then audit type. So in audit type we have a drop down. So in this drop down we have many more options. So we want capture package name. So we can select package name. Then we need to capture machine name. So we can select machine name. Then we need to capture execution start time. So we can select execution start time. Now we need to select username, then task name. Now click on OK. Now go to on our destination. So we want to load data in our flat file destination. So we can drag and drop this flat file destination, then connect with audit transformation. Now we need to configure our destination. Now double click on this flat file destination, then we have to specify flat file connection manager. So click on new. We want to generate a delimited file, then click on OK. Here we need to select file name. So we can browse. We want to generate a file with the name of audit. Then click on open. So column names in first data row, we can select this checkbox. Then go to on columns. So as we can see, we are getting sale number, sale order date, customer ID, quantity, value. So now I gonna click on OK. Then go to on mapping. So inside mapping we can see we are getting sale order number, date, customer ID, quantity, value and country. So these 6 columns are coming from source and we are getting package name, machine name, execution start time, username and task name from audit transformation. So it will generate all these columns. Now click on OK. So we have done our destination as well. Now we need to execute our package. So click on start. So go to one folder. As we can see, file has been generated with the name of audit. Now we need to open this file. As we can see, it has captured all the information. So we are getting these six columns from source, then package name, machine name, execution start time, username and task name from audit transformation. So I hope you have understand how we can use audit transformation to capture the audit information. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.